For the given question, the question is to find the minimum cut in a graph. To be able to understand the minimum cut in the graph, just understand this as a normal graph. Now do not consider any flow, anything in this, any source, anything, nothing. आपको कट करना है इस ग्राफ को. सो इन वी डैश यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट टू ए एंड बी वर्टिसेस विच आर बोथ सबसेट्स ऑफ योर ओरिजिनल सेट ऑफ वर्टिसेस सच दैट ए में एस सोर्स नोड मस्ट बी देयर एंड द सिंक नोड मस्ट बी देयर इन बी. और यू कैन से दैट देयर आर टू सेपरेट नोड्स which must be in A and B, and they are mutually exclusive sets. There is no node which is repeated in any of the set, which is a part of both the sets. So what we are trying to do over here is, I'm trying to look for a cut. Let us try to see what a cut is. Supposedly I'm cutting my graph like this. So this is a part where I've cut my graph in two halves, so that if I am considering the set A, so I have cut all of this into first part S, A, B, C. They are becoming the part of one set. And I am taking another set which are having the rest of D and T. This is another set. Now if I want to find out the cost of the cut, that is what we tried to see. Cost of the cut in the graph we are trying to find out. So if I am trying to find out the cost of this cut, so what is going to happen here? I find out the cut edges. What are my cut edges? There are three edges, 1, 2 and 3. These are my cut edges. Now cut edges are essentially the edges which are going out from A to B. Please note, A wale se B mein ja rahi hai. So that, and I am not saying it in reverse, A to T is one edge, B to T is another edge, and C to D is the third edge, which is a cut edge here. Agar koi edge vapas andar aa rahi hoti, then we would not have considered that as a cut edge. So there are three cut edges, A to T, B to T and C to D. Now if you want to find the cost of the cut, it is the sum total of the weights on the edges. What are the weights on the edges? A to T hai, B to T and C to D. So if I am finding out the weight on these edges, it is 5 plus 8 plus 10. So it comes out to be 23. So the cost of the current cut comes out to be 23. Ye clear hua sabko? I am again repeating, cost of the cut is the sum total of weights of the edges going out from A to B. Since it's a directed graph, A से outgoing edges होंगी. If it is an undirected graph और अगर हम खुद उसमें directions add करें, then it does not make a difference. But for an directed graph, make sure you are only taking the edges going out from all of these nodes to some of the node in B subset. So let us try to see another possible cut in this graph. Let me take another cut. Which is not the same. इस कट की हमारे पास कॉस्ट आई 23, फर्स्ट कट दैट वी आर कंसिडरिंग. लेट अस टेक अनदर कट, नॉट दिस. लेट मी कट द ग्राफ इन, आई कैन कट द ग्राफ इन एनी मैनर सो दैट एस बिकम्स अ पार्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट एंड द माई टी इज बिकमिंग द पार्ट ऑफ द अदर. सपोजिडली आई एम कटिंग द ग्राफ लाइक दिस. दिस इज ऑल्सो अ कट इन माई ग्राफ वेयर ए सेट इज हैविंग एस सी एंड बी. And B set is having A, sorry, D is also a part of this only. S, C, B and D are a part of A set. A and T are a part of the B set. So if I am talking about the cut edges, A to B is not a cut edge. I will repeat, A to B is not a cut edge. Why? Because it is going from B wala to A. This edge is not what we are considering. We are only going outgoing edges from these. I hope I am making it very clear to all of you. I am only considering outgoing edges. So the cut edge is B to T. Another cut edge which I am having is S to A. And another cut edge which I am having is D to T. Is it clear to all? The cut edges which I am having in this example right now is S to A, B to T and D to T. These are my cut edges. Edge from A to B is not a cut edge. So if I am adding the total weight to find out the cost of my cut, S to A is 10, B to T is 8, D to T is 12. So if I am sum totaling them, I get a 30 over here. Yes or no? Till here am I making myself clear to all of you? Yes, class. So this cut is costing me 30. Now the problem of finding a minimum cut in the graph is that try to cut the graph in two parts where the cost of the cut is minimum. Cut koi bhi ho sakta hai. I can have many cuts possible in the graph. But the cut with the minimum cost, that is the edges going from A to B, should be minimum. It is possible that A only has one single node. It is possible that B only has one single node. But minimum ek node dono mein hona compulsory hai. And there are exclusive nodes in both the sets that cover all the nodes. So sare nodes ko divide karna, that is the minimum cut. Now we say that there is a theorem that we are saying that as the minimum cut theorem, which says that if I find the maximum flow in a graph, then the residual network of my graph, if I remove the edges with zero residual capacity, then the residual network of my graph helps me find the minimum cut. Let us see how do I do that. So first of all, let me apply the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm here. So let us simply try to apply the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm. When I am applying the Ford-Fulkerson algorithm, I am looking initially for the path, augmenting path with minimum edges. Source it. Sink तक मुझे path पे जाना है. I have a possibility S to A to T. I have a possibility S C B T. I have a possibility S B S A B T. I have a possibility S C B T. All these are possible paths. First of all, I am considering the augmenting path with minimum number of edges on it. So the augmenting path which I am having right now with the minimum number of edges is S to A and A to T. So this is the path I am considering. So I'm writing the first path which I'm considering is S to A, A to T. What is the bottleneck on my path?
5.
5 happens to be the bottleneck on this path. That is the minimum capacity on any edge on the path. That means I can send a flow of 5 units on this path. So I'm sending a flow of 5 units on the path. Is it clear? Now 5 units flow is sent here. Now, yes dear, beta, on the path S to A and A to T, there are only two edges. S to A, the capacity is 10. A to T, the capacity is 5. So, jab humare paas do pipes hai, do pipe humne jod diye, ek mein 10 liter of water can go, ek mein 5 liter of water can go. So, if I am sending 10, in the entire network only 5 liters will be traveling. Rest will be left and it will go later on only. Pehle 5 liters jayega, uske baad hi baad mein 5 liters ja sakte. Yes or no?
Yes,
ma'am. So that is why the edge with the minimum capacity makes the bottleneck of any augmenting path. Bottleneck jitna flow we push onto the network. So I have pushed 5 units of flow on my network. Right? So consider now the next augmenting path. If I am considering a residual graph over here, so I am making a residual graph which is the very same as the graph that I have created. It has to be same with the graph that I am creating. Original graph mein koi change nahi aayega, this remains. This is my original graph, this should remain. What am I only doing is, whatever flow I have added on the network, I make reverse edges of that flow. So I am making a reverse edge here for 5 units and a reverse edge here for 5 units. Because this is an extra flow which we have given, so we can remove it. So this becomes my residual network. Our residual network mein bachi hui capacity mein, find out where you can flow more. So you can still go from S to A, A to B and B to T. You can also go S to C, C to D, D to D. All of them are taking 3 edges, so you can choose any path of your choice. It is completely up to you. Supposedly, I am choosing. You can choose S to C, C to D, D to D. It is again completely up to you. Will not make any difference in the maximum flow that you are finding in the graph. It will not make any difference in the minimum cut you are finding. So supposedly here you are choosing, I will take 2 examples. So supposedly you are choosing S to C, C to D and D to T. What is the cut, bottleneck on the path? The path I am choosing is S to C to D to T. So the bottleneck here is 10. Since it's 10, that means 10 units of flow can be added to the network. So I am adding a 10 units flow onto the network using this path. And I am updating my residual graph by creating a reverse flow of 10 units on the path. Right? I again look for some more capacity. I still have 5 units can be sent from here. 4 units can still be sent from here. So I am sending, supposedly I am selecting S to A, A to B and B to T. So the path I am selecting, you can again choose, since all of them are 3 edge path, you can choose any. I am taking say S to A, B, A to B and B to T. Technically, you should select a path with maximum capacity, maximum value of bottleneck if the number of edges is the same. Agar same number of edges hai, to jiska bottleneck sabse zyada value ka hai, aap sabse zyada flow bhejna chahte ho, that path you should select. So if I am choosing S to A, A to B and B to T, the bottleneck is 5. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
So you are choosing this path क्योंकि अगर आप S to C, C to B, B to T choose करोगे तो bottleneck 4 आ जाएगा. That is why I am choosing bottleneck 5 वाला path before, so that I will get the correct answer. So when I am choosing this path, let me add that much more. So since the bottleneck is 5, I have added 5 more units here. I have added 5 more units here and I have added 5 units here to go from source to the sink. Showing the same on my residual graph, I have added a 5 units of reverse flow here, 5 units reverse flow here, and this reverse flow is updated to be 10. Now I am looking for path. I still have S to C, C to B and B to T. Yes or no? What is the bottleneck on this graph, on this path, sorry? It is 3. The bottleneck on this path is 3. The residual capacity is 8 minus 5. 3 units can more be sent from B to T. 13 units can be sent here. 4 can be sent. So 3 becomes the bottleneck. That means I am pushing 3 units of flow from here. So this becomes 13. This becomes 3 on 13 and this becomes 8 on 13. Representing the same in my residual graph now, I am adding a 3 units of reverse flow here. 3 units of reverse flow here. And I am updating this to be 10 plus 3, 13. So this becomes my residual graph. Is there any more augmenting path left where I can send more units of flow? See, S to A, 0 capacity. S to C capacity of 1 is there. C to B ki capacity hai, C to D ki koi capacity nahi. But from B you cannot go anywhere. So there is no more flow that can happen now. Yes or no? So the final path that you just chose, I have missed that path, that was S to C, C to B and B to T with 3 units of flow that you have chosen. Now after this, this no more augmenting path is possible. So this becomes my final residual network. Let us calculate the maximum flow that we are getting. If I add the maximum flow, you can see how much flow is going out or how much flow is going into the sink. It is 10 plus 13, 23. Or it is 5 plus 8 plus 10, again a 23. Or you can calculate the bottlenecks of all the path. 5 plus 10, 15. Plus 5 is 20, again plus 3 is 23. Kaise bhi calculate karo, 23 becomes the maximum possible flow in my network. And I am saying, whatever is the maximum possible flow in the network, it is same as the value of the cost of minimum cut for the given graph. Now how do I find out that cut? So let us see. Till here everybody is clear? Anybody any doubt? Good. So now I am saying remove the edges with residual capacity 0 for my final residual graph. See what are the edges with 0 capacity. S to A, this is not possible. The residual capacity is 0. So I am removing. Or koi edge remove nahi karni hai. Dhyan rakhna. Both ways ki edges still existed. Then I am having C to D, the residual capacity is 0. So I am removing it. I am having B to T, the residual capacity is 0, so I am removing this also. A to T, the residual capacity is 0, I am removing this also. And A to B also, the residual capacity is 0, so I am removing this. Till here, is it clear? Now, S say what is reachable, S to C is reachable and S C to B is also reachable. So, source se kaun se node reachable hai? Clearly, the nodes which are reachable from source are B and C, and the nodes which are not reachable are the rest of the nodes. So this is how I've cut my graph. SCB is part of the A. So I have got, I can say that if I am writing my A set, I am getting S, B and C to be the part of set A, and if I am writing my B set, cut wala set, so A, D and T are part of my second set. Yes or no? Let us now calculate the cost of this cut. Now I have to calculate the cost of this cut. A yes or no? Let us try to calculate the cost of my cut. The cut which I am getting over here is, let me draw it. I am cutting a cut like this and this. This is the cut I am getting. Aisa hi cut mil raha hai na hame. So if I try to find out the cut edges are the edges going from A to B. So A to B, S to A is an edge. Another edge which I am getting is B to T. Now I am not taking the edge A to B, I am taking the edge B to T, and I am taking the edge C to D. Yes class. Kya cheez? A to B वाली एज क्यों नहीं ले रहे? The question
yes.
is because A is falling in the second set and B is falling in the first set. I am only finding the flow which is going out from node A to B. I am not following the reverse. If I follow, then I will have to subtract that much. Or you can say that I want to see how much total flow is incoming to T. Ye samajh aa raha hai? Yes or no? What will happen if I am... Now since A is not connected to T also, this is a special case here. I am not having A connected to D. Jo mera residual graph tha, usme A alag tha, D and T were connected. Yes or no? A was not connected to T. So when I am considering the flow from S to A, the cut edge, the flow that is going here, you can see is 10. But 10 units are not flowing to T. 10 units are not flowing from source to the sink. They are not flowing from... So that is not what the maximum flow is there. How much is flowing from S to T? How much is flowing from S to T? From here, 5, exactly, 5 to A se B mein vapas aa gaye na. So 5 units are only flowing because there are 2 now. Zero weight wali edge, ye bhi hai, ye bhi hai. Ye bhi residual graph mein hat gayi, ye bhi residual graph mein hat gayi. Please understand that. So what is happening is, only 5 units are flowing from this edge to T. So I will only be calculating 5 units as the capacity of my this edge. B to T, I have 8. and C to D I have 10. If I total them, it will be 23 once again. That is the value of my minimum cut which I have found. Because A to B has come back, that is not which is going out. That is why, and A is not connected to sink. Residual graph mein A or T connected nahi the, I am repeating this. That is why you are finding S to T kitna gaya. S to T via A only 5 units gaya tha. Baki to via B or C gaya hoga na. Bhai S se A mein jo gaya, that should have gone to T from us. Baki to B or C node se gaya hoga. Yes or no? Are you all understanding this now? Is it now clear why the minimum cut I have got is of course 23?